Hey guys!
Alright guys, we're here today to check out the latest video from Demons and Wizards, Diabolic. I feel like it says this is official video, so it's not a, like a lyric video or a visual. I hate visualizer, that's like the worst. But anyways.
Just choose between the two.
Yeah, visualizer is kind of pregnant. It's kind of like in between.
You're never kind of pregnant.
Yeah, either you are or you're not. But anyways, Demons and Wizards, they have a new album coming out in February of 2020. This is the first single from that. I believe this is the first single, as far as I can recall. This is the first single from this from the new record that they're releasing. And by the way, I am one of many lucky ones that got to see Demons and Wizards during their North American tour this past, I'm going to say summer. Yeah, it was in August.
Yeah,
it was after
that.
We came back from Finland. This is no bullshit. It's not because we're about to check Demons and Wizards.
It was one of those concerts that you came back and you were waiting to tell me something. You kicked open my door. You're like, I saw Valhalla live.
I heard.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't see. It's a song. You don't see it. I mean, I saw the performance.
Exactly.
I'm just rectifying there. I saw Valhalla. No, I didn't die. I didn't see Valhalla.
You weren't holding your sword.
Yeah, I wasn't holding my sword or my axe. But anyways, it's one of the best live performances I've ever seen, period. I'm not talking about just in 2019. I'm talking in general. One of the best concerts that I've ever been to. I was at the front on the rail. I enjoyed every single second of it. Absolutely phenomenal performance. Absolutely phenomenal. And I got a guitar pick from Jake.
Yeah.
From Witherfell, by the way. He plays with Witherfell and Ice Earth. I mean, this guy's everywhere.
Yeah.
Great guitar player. I'm not sure if I'm a big fan of him playing with his shirt all the way unbuttoned to his belly button. But, hey, who am I to judge?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Well, technically, I am judging now, but, you know, whatever. Anyways, Demons and Wizards, Diabolic, brand new song, brand new video, new album. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
All right, let's do this. All right.
Thank you.
I have to fix my beard after this. Wow. I mean, I had expectations coming into this track. I have expectations coming into the album, right?
They're blown.
This song just like this song way exceeded my expectations. My God, that guitar riff. No, not that one. That melody is like haunting as hell. I mean, like, that's one of the darkest melodies.
I could take that little clip and loop it for like a couple hours, and I could sleep with that shit all night.
I know, but with his voice or without? Because at the beginning, the song starts without.
It doesn't matter for me because I can take
his voice at the end. Like, it makes it even darker.
The thing is, it made my eyes so heavy, and it kind of transported me, and I was just swaying because that's absolutely beautiful.
That melody is absolutely beautiful,
and then the vocals in the background of the melody.
The darkness, the melody itself has a lot of darkness. I thought the song, when it goes back into that melody towards the end of the song, before the vocals come in, I'm thinking, are they going to finish off the song this way? Because that's how the song started. It was almost a 1 minute intro, just of that melody, and I'm thinking, are they going to close it off like that? No. But then I look at the time, there's still like 2 minutes to go on the song. There's no way they're going to close it off like this for 2 minutes. Then they brought the vocals in to extend it. I was like, oh my God. Like,
I could have a whole song of just that.
That was incredible. But I know I'm talking about the really heavy riff. Oh man. That was like, it was like horses marching into, not marching, like, you know,
galloping into battle.
It was absolutely glorious. Like, it was so powerful. It had such a heavy tone to it. Talk about making a song that is heavy, powerful, dynamic, fast moving, all together, all in one. Because sometimes when you have songs like this and there's a riff or a drums that come in and they're heavy, they tend to slow down the rest of the song. Everything kind of tends to slow a little bit down. It's not the case here. Like, no. The song is just like, Once you get over that intro, that dark melody intro, the song doesn't stop. It's just like absolutely insanity from that point on all the way through to towards the end when that melody comes back again, and then you get Hensi's voice in the background. His vocals are absolutely magnificent. This whole song is just like, it's just incredible. Incredible.
Oh my.
I'm so excited.
I still can't get over that, the way it ended, with the absolutely beautiful melody. I still can't get over that.
But don't you think that the vocals helped?
It did.
Because the melody itself... It
helped me, but the vocals was the driving force of the trance it kind of puts you in.
Yeah. I agree with you on that. The song has a slow build-up because it uses the same melody at the build-up. I didn't think it was going to come back to the melody at the end. Maybe really like towards the end, like after the chorus, maybe throw in that melody so the song comes full circle. I was not expecting to go 2 minutes of that at the end with the vocals in the vocals, background.
But that's what let it go for 2 minutes.
That's the only way you could do it.
Yeah.
Man, the whole song. I could listen. You know what I was looking at the time? The song is 8 minutes long. And I'm like, I could go for another eight, yeah. Another 16, whatever. This is one of those songs you can put on loop. And you absolutely don't get tired of it. It's just so well crafted. You know, power metal, but haunting at the same time. Yeah. With this really dark feel to it.
Like doom power metal.
Yeah, it has a little bit of like almost like...
A doom and gloom feel to
it. A doom and gloom feel to it, specifically with that guitar melody.
Yeah.
That guitar, and when the vocals come in, then for sure. But what a powerful song. I'm really excited about the prospects of checking out the album in February. The album comes out in February. I talked to the PR guys from Demons and Wizards, and I'm probably going to be getting the album midway through January for a review. So I'm really excited about the prospects. I'm crossing my fingers that I get to do another interview with Hensi. I did one about Blind Guardian, the Twilight Orchestra. We got to chat for like 45 minutes about that album. And he said to me that he wants to talk to me once this album comes out. So I'm making my due diligence, my request to see if that happens. Because this album, based on this song alone, I'm sold.
Yeah.
Like, this is already on my top 10 list albums of 2020, and I've only heard one song. But based on this song alone, it's freaking epic.
Well, you can add it to your best albums of this year, too.
How?
Just make it an EP. It's just this one song.
This is a single. It's not even an EP. Now,
best singles.
One best singles to be released in 2019. This song is absolutely glorious. Now, the only thing that makes me really think, why did I didn't get to ask him that when I talked to him, because I wasn't talking to him about Demons and Wizards. I was talking to him about Twilight Orchestra. One of the things that really befuddled me, or like, I'm trying to find a word, like that really like
surprised you.
Yeah, that made me scratch my head. Here I am trying to use big words and I'm failing. So one thing that surprised me is that they went on tour with Demons and Wizards before the album came out. And now that the album is coming out, they're not going to go on tour because they just toured in 2019. So he said to me that that's it. The album comes out, there's no Demons and Wizards tour. It's kind of strange though. Like, you go on tour with your old material leading up to the release of your new album.
And you're not going to go on tour.
And then you're not going to go on tour when the new album comes out? To me, that's kind of strange.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
But you know what that means. The new album comes out in February. That's before Summer Breeze.
No, they're not playing festival. I don't think they're playing anything. Because,
really?
Yeah, because when I talked to him, he said to me that he's working on new Blind Guardian material because they're looking at releasing a new album, Blind Guardian is, at the beginning of 2021. So the whole year is going to be dedicated to finishing off that record to release the album in January. Then they're going to be doing in 2021, they're going to be doing some Twilight Orchestra shows, like with a whole orchestra, which is kind of cool. Yeah. So he's working on that. And then obviously they're going to go on tour for Blind Guardian. I wouldn't be surprised if they throw a Demons and Wizards song on the set of Blind Guardian when they go on tour. I wouldn't be surprised. But from everything that I've talked to him and everything that I know, once the album comes out, that's it. There's no tour, no festivals, no nothing. Because they did they played Wacken this year, 2019, right? So they've played all the festivals.
They've done everything this year.
They did everything this year. They did a tour in North America. They said it was going to be the only time that they would ever tour as Demons and Wizards in North America. That's why I didn't want to miss that show. So it's kind of strange that you tour the year before your album comes out, and then when your album comes out,
you're not
going to
tour with
Coitus Interruptus.
Yeah,
you know, it's kind of strange. Maybe Ice Earth has an album coming out as well, because they haven't released an album in a couple of years now, right? So maybe they haven't. So maybe there's other things in the mix, and maybe this year was the only time they could get together as a band and tour, regardless of when the album was coming out. Maybe that was the reasoning behind it, and maybe it was a way for them to promote the upcoming release versus releasing and then going on the road. Or maybe they knew they were not going to be able to go on the road, so at least let's go on the road before. I don't know the exact logistics, but it's still kind of sad and kind of strange, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
What band releases an album and goes on tour before the album?
I hope they change their mind about like festivals though.
Man, I think it would be amazing if they did, but I don't see it, because they played a lot of the big festivals in 2019. So a lot of festivals are not going to book the same band back-to-back years.
Yeah.
It's just not going to happen, right? What a great song, though. I'm really excited about the album. All right, guys, this is it for today, but come back tomorrow. We'll have more videos for you. See you guys.
See ya.